Okay, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to another episode of College and Career Pathways, where every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 2 p.m., we provide you with information on various colleges and universities, financial aid resources, technical schools, training programs, skilled trade professions, employment opportunities, career exploration, and career readiness skills, all designed to help you make the best career decisions possible. I am Toni Cureton, your host, and today we have the distinct pleasure of having Shaw University from North Carolina here, Mr. Ryan Wright. Thank you so much for joining us. We're so glad to have you, and welcome. You are muted.
Thank you so much for that introduction, and good afternoon, everyone. I am Ryan Wright, admissions counselor and recruiter here at Shaw University. We're located in downtown Raleigh, North Carolina. So we are right in the downtown heart of the state's capital. So that's a plus for our university. And it's a lot of history here. We're going to talk a little bit about that. I have a video, then I'm going to kind of talk about Shaw University and the different programs that we have to offer. And then you can ask me any questions that you want or that you may have after I get done presenting, okay? All right, so where I'm gonna share my screen, I have a video.
Welcome to Shaw University, a place where history is made, leaders emerge, and transformation begins. Founded in 1865, we were the first HBCU in the Southern United States. Our vibrant campus is a unique living and learning community. We are located in the heart of downtown Raleigh and a short drive from Research Triangle Park, the largest technology research park in the country. We are a place where opportunity surrounds you. IBM, GlaxoSmithKline Pharmaceuticals, Duke Energy are just three of the many well-known companies that offer internships and hire our graduates. Within walking distance of campus, you can attend networking events or take advantage of internships. You can even launch your own business at Shaw University's Innovation and Entrepreneurship Center. At Shaw University, you will learn from dedicated professors and meet lifelong friends. You can take part in over 30 different academic and service organizations. Get involved in Greek life, sports, or the Platinum Sound, Shaw University's notable marching band. From its start as the first historically Black university in the Southern United States to the vibrant campus we are today, Shaw University is the right place to grow, learn, and explore.
All right, so that was just a small video about Shaw University. So as stated in the video, Shaw University was founded on Monday, December 1st, 1865 by Dr. Henry Martin Tupper. So Shaw University, we currently have around 1,300 students here on campus. So we're a small university. So that was a plus for me as well. And I'm kind of going to tell you all about my story, or, you know, just to give you some insight about the good things that we do here at Shaw University. So we have about 1,300 students. Our admissions requirements is a 2.0 GPA. We do not accept background checks, letters of recommendations, or essays. And also, we are test optional due to COVID. So because of COVID, we stopped taking SAT and ACT test scores. I'm sorry, you guys. Just had lunch, so I'm just, you know, getting back in the groove of things. So we are test optional. So if you know, haven't taken any tests, or if a student haven't taken a test, then that's fine as well. We would just need to know that you haven't had a chance to, you know, take a test, or whatever the case may be, that's fine as well. We also do take transfer credits. So in order to be a transfer student, you will have to have at least 12 credit hours that can transfer in order to be considered a transfer student. If you don't have 12 credit hours, you will be considered a first year freshman here at Shaw University. So that's just a little bit about our admissions requirement. And in chat box, I put some information about our financial aid and our scholarships. And I also put our FAFSA code down there and also our majors. So we have about 20 academic majors here on campus. Our top five would be biology, education, social work, mass communications, and computer science. So those are some of our top majors and programs here that we have at Shaw University. If you have any questions, feel free to unmute yourself, ask, or put it in the chat box. Athletics, we are Division II. We are part of the CIAA. We are part of the CIAA, so we are Division II. We have 13 sports here on campus. So women's sports, we have women's basketball, volleyball, softball, bowling, track and field, cross country, tennis, and soccer. Men's sports, we have football, basketball, soccer, tennis, cross country. So those are the sports that we offer here at Shaw University, okay? Any questions thus far? No? Okay, perfect. So Shaw University, in order to graduate, let me just go into this because I know this is kind of what a lot of people ask about, what does Shaw University do for students after graduation? So Shaw University, again, is downtown. So we are pretty much in the middle of a lot of different businesses and different corporations that are located downtown. So a lot of those businesses come to Shaw University and ask, we need some students to complete internships. Perfect. So what Shaw University has done is every student must complete an internship before they graduate. That was a plus for me when I was choosing schools. I am an alum here at Shaw University, that all students have and must complete an internship before they graduate. And I've seen students internship at NASA, and then after the internship was over, I've seen them get offered full-time jobs. I have seen students do student teaching, and now they are teaching at the local elementary or high schools. So the internship part works. And then we have an entrepreneurship center here at Shaw University. So you could take your business plan and go talk to our career development director, and they can help you launch that business that you're trying to launch. Okay. So that was a plus. We have a career development center who will help you with, resume writing, helping with your resume, helping you find internships, helping you find jobs. If you we have students that may not be fortunate enough to come with professional dress clothes. Here at Shaw University, we have a career closet to where any student can go in the closet and get some brand new dress clothes, dress shoes, if you have an interview. So that's just a little bit about what Shaw University has to offer. Student life as well, we have a little bit over 32 different student-led organizations here at Shaw University. You can start your own organization as well at Shaw University. So we do have student government. I served as a student government president in 2018-2019. So you can join student activities boards. So you can plan homecoming. You can plan different events. We have book clubs. We have modeling troops, dance teams. We have fraternities and sororities here as well. We have The whole Divine Nine. We have a lot of academic social fellowships as well, and academic fellowships as well within departments so that you can join. We have a great Honors College. Our Honors College is great. They actually just had a Honors College ceremony yesterday, and all the new members of Honors College received a free computer. They received some other things as well to help them with their education as well. Residence halls. We have 4 residence halls here at Shaw University. We have 2 female residence halls and 2 male residence halls, one for upperclassmen and one for freshmen and sophomore. Freshmen are required to stay on campus unless it's approved by our Vice President of Student Affairs, Dr. Keith Powell. In our residence halls, we have three style rooms. We have a single room, so where you could be in a room by yourself. And then we have a double, where it's you and one other roommate. And then we have a three-party room, where it would be you and 2 other people in your room. We do not have co-ed, or we do not have suite style. So everything is pretty much set up the dorm style here at Shaw University. It's a community. So we're pretty much going to share bathrooms in the hallway, in the hall. So every hall has a bathroom that you can share with the people living on your hall. We do have common areas. You have laundry, you have a whole health center. So if you get sick, we do have doctors and nurses that are on duty all day. So that's a plus as well. If I'm going too fast, please, slow me down. If I'm talking too much, you want to ask questions, please feel free. So the student life is, very important when you're choosing colleges or universities or, even community colleges. It's very important. Academic life is very important as well. But I want you to always go somewhere where you will be happy and comfortable, to where you're not staying inside of your residence hall. I want you to get out. Networking is key. I don't know, I'm sure you all probably heard this before, or somebody have said this before. Most of the time, it's not about what you know, it's about who you know. So to me, networking was very key for me to get to where I am today. So networking, meeting new people. So when you go to a college or university, you're going to meet new people. So you have to be comfortable enough to, meet new people, especially if you're going to travel out of state or even to a different town in your state. You have to be comfortable. And I will always recommend touring the school, always set up a campus tour. We have our campus tours that are open now. You can always come on campus and tour, each building and residence halls, talk to some students, talk to some professors, just to see if the school is the right fit for you, okay? So for me, I graduated from Shaw University. What made me decide to come to Shaw was the family atmosphere. Shaw University is very family oriented. Once again, 1,300 students, 16-1 student faculty ratio. So class sizes are very small. The general ed courses may be maybe 30 people in that class, but once you start getting to your major classes, it will probably no more than 15 people. In one of my classes, it was me and 2 other people. So it was 3 people in one of my classes before. So the professors actually know you by first and last name, and you're not, just a number. I've actually had a professor call my mom before because I missed class when I was sick, and I forgot to email the professor, and they contacted my mom. because I wasn't answering my phone. So they actually care. They give you their personal cell phone numbers. They give you their office. They have office hours. Our professors really, really, really want our students to succeed. We have a great, great tutorial center, better known here as the Writing Center. So the Writing Center is a tutorial center that you can go and get tutoring. If you need help with a paper, if you need help in math, science, whatever, we have people in every department here that is able to help each student succeed when they come to the Writing Center. And we also have a great academic success center, library. We have two libraries on campus. I wish they was open later than they close at 11 p.m., but sometimes, you might, want to do a late night study. But we do have computer labs in each of the residence halls that students can go down at any time, do work, study, pretty much handle their business, outside the classroom with their work, do their homework, books. So something that Shaw University has decided to do was include eBooks. So we're pretty much we're leaning more towards all technology now. Before we was having to buy $500 books. Now a free ebook comes with the course that you're taking. So that's just something that I feel like I wish they would have when I was here, but now they have now. And it actually helped our recruitment as well. Because books can be a lot, it can add up. Especially if you rent it, you still have to take care of it. So the ebook, the ebook thing was a brilliant idea, especially at a campus, like this with, the students and professors, especially with COVID and us going virtual, not, face-to-face, you can't have a face-to-face class. So that was pretty much a plus. Also, academic-wise, you will, be required to meet with your academic advisor. I always tell students when they come, your best friend can be your best friend, but when you come, to here, you have a new best friend. Your best friend is your academic advisor, because your academic advisor will keep you on track for graduation. They're going to keep you on track to make sure you're taking the necessary classes you're going to take. They're going to make sure you're not falling behind your classes, or you're showing up to your classes. So always tell folks, when you come to Shaw University, you're going to always have a new best friend, which will be your academic advisor, because they will email you, they will contact you, if they see something, have come up on your Moodle, which is our Blackboard. So if they see something, if your grade is slipping, they will, contact you. And I think that's what stands Shaw University, apart from a lot of different institutions, because we have professors who actually, care. I'm not saying that it's not like that everywhere, but our professors actually go the extra mile. And I still have relationships with my professors that I had in 2015 when I came. I still keep up with them, they still keep up with me. Some of them, they are great. They do letters of recommendations for the master programs, for jobs, whatever the case may be. Professors really want their students, to succeed and to really be a global leader, because that's a part of our mission statements. So our professor and our academic affairs department is very, 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 I want to say, the best. It really changed me, and they helped a lot with students moving from a different state. I've seen some professors do things for people that say we have a lot of students from California. California is one of our top 10 states. So we do actually have a lot of students from the West Coast. So when they come, you know, it's a bit different. It's a cultural shock, you know, things of that nature. So we do have programs and we do have people on campus that will help assist to make that transition, you know, smooth. When I came in to Charlotte University, I'm a mama's boy, still am. So it was hard for me to leave my mama, even though I was going only 30 minutes down the road. But, you know, being at Shaw, getting active, being involved, joining different organizations, that helped out a lot because I wasn't, you know, thinking about home as much as I was when I first, you know, came here. And another thing, getting involved. Here at Shaw University, student involvement is key. We take pride in our student organizations here at Shaw University because we, at Shaw University, we know without students, there would be no university. And we really, really, really do live by that. So without students, there would be no university here. So we take pride. So if our students, you know, want to have an event, they're going to have that event because we know it's important, you know, to them. So I always tell folks, not even just here, wherever you go, get involved, whatever you do, get involved, find something or, you know, something that could help you focus on, you know, what you need to focus on or find something that can not be academic all the time, if that makes sense. Find something that can get your mind off of that, because if you're, you know, coming to college just for academics, that's fine as well, but you need to get involved. You need to find an organization. If it's the University Book Club, the University Gospel, whatever the case may be, I would definitely recommend you find it. Go to the career fairs, go to the student panels, go to different student organization fairs that they may have. Just find information. And we have a lot of career fairs and student organization fairs here at Shaw University to where we have outside businesses come and, you know, recruit. We have Parks and Rec. We have a relationship with Parks and Recs here in Raleigh and in Durham as well. And I've seen them, you know, give people jobs. We have a program to where our students can receive a free passport. And I was one of those students that got a free passport. So we do give students opportunities to travel. We have studied abroad. We haven't done it this year, you know, due to COVID. But our last, they took five students. Where was it? But they took five students somewhere for a semester. So they did study abroad. So we do have study abroad. We do have different programs similar to study abroad. So you can, you know, get involved in that here at Shaw University. And also a plus about Shaw University, and I'm gonna stop for questions. Another plus we have here at Shaw University is our CRC program. So what that is we have Raleigh is considered a college town, as we must say. So it's six colleges and universities pretty much right in a, so we all kind of in a circle. So it's North Carolina State, Shaw, St. Augustine's, William Peace, Meredith, and Wake Tech. So we're all pretty much in a circle. So any of our students can take classes free of charge at any of their surrounding schools. So say if Shaw didn't offer a class that you need, you can go to NC State and take that class for free and it will transfer, so you won't have to wait extra semester to graduate, and vice versa at different schools. We have students that attend NC State that are taking classes here or at St. Aug. So that's a plus, and that started 3 years ago as well, and it's been very, very beneficial, and it helps students not panic as much, you know, if they need a class, they don't want to stay an extra semester, so that has actually helped with across the board at all these schools. So Shaw University, I would say, is probably the best choice if you're looking for something small, family-oriented, you know, get away in the middle of downtown. It's always something to do. It's always a festival downtown. It's always, you know, a food truck rodeo. So it's always something, you know, to do here at Shaw University. And I think that's what, you know, stands us apart from, you know, many other institutions, okay? So I want to stop. If anybody have any questions, feel free to, you know, ask, you know, or any comments.
Ryan, what's the tuition cost?
Yeah, so the tuition is $24,994.24. But I can tell you this, nobody pays that full amount with the amount of people that we have on scholarships or, you know, through financial aid. And here at Shaw University, we started something, grant aid, so it's a merit-based. So pretty much every student that comes in with a 2.0, which is our minimum GPA requirement, up to a 4.0 will get some type of funding from the university. So let's say if you have a 2.5, we may give you up to $5,000. And if you have a 4.0, that could be a full ride. Or if you scored a 24 on a ACT, you can get up to $15,000 a year on your tuition. So Shaw University, we really had to find ways to help students because 24,000 is a lot. You know, it is a lot. So Shaw University does have programs and tools to help you with that.
Do you guys have any questions for Ryan?
Don't be shy now.
What is your completion rate, percentage wise, if you know? Because I really like the how you elaborated on how close the tutoring is between faculty and student and the availability of opportunities to shore your strengths up in your classes.
Our completion rate, I don't know the exact number because it changed. I know it did change, but I will say that we do have most of the time since I've been here, we have had almost 80% graduation class, almost 80% of the, you know, students graduated, and the students that didn't graduate is because they, you know, transferred from a different school to here. So the numbers are kind of always off because when we do our percentages, we don't add our transfer students, if that makes sense for some reason. I don't know why, but the students that transfer in, we don't add them. But our completion rate, since I've been here, it's been pretty good. Every school, you know, can be better with that. And another thing that Shaw University done to, you know, better that was adding the CRC with, you could take a class at a different, you know, university locally, because if we don't offer a class the spring semester and you do the graduate in the spring semester, that will hurt our, you know, graduation rate. It's gotten a lot better in their program work. So we don't have any medical programs. We have biology pre-athletic training and kinesiotherapy. So we do have those programs here, but we don't have a medical, like a public health or a nursing program here. And we do offer scholarships. So to current high school students, if you are a senior, we could offer you a scholarship. So we do offer, you know, scholarships to current high school students. Good questions. Any other questions?
And so checking the chat, I'm looking at students can get a fee waiver for the application fee.
Yes. So the fee waiver actually changed. So I'm going to put the new fee waiver in.
Do you have a rolling enrollment, or is there a date that students need to apply by in order to be?
So we are open enrollment, so you can apply whenever. So we're pretty much open enrollment throughout the year, so you can apply whenever.
Good deal.
So we really don't have a maximum number. But we do have a minimum, which is 12 credit hours. So you must have at least 12 credits that will transfer over to be considered a transfer student.
Did that $24,000 tuition cost include room and board or no?
Yeah, so that includes room and board as well. So that includes everything, your technology fee, athletic fee, a student activities fee, room and board. And it also covers, you know, your classes that you're paying for. So that includes everything. And that's per year, per year. Any other questions? Hold on. Great questions, by the way. Great questions.
Okay, you guys, if you don't have any more questions, then we will wrap this up. Ryan, we thank you so much for your time and for sharing your experience and all of the great information about Shaw. You guys have such an excellent program. I love, 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 love your embracing of students during their educational experience, making sure that nobody, you know, gets lost or falls short or gets left behind if it can at all be helped. I absolutely love that, because a lot of times students go to college and they just get lost in, you know, the crowd, never really making connections and never really knowing where to go when they need to reach out for help and assistance. And your program sounds like it really covers all those bases, because I've not even heard of a college professor that would contact your parent to inquire as to why you're not in school. You know, that's really awesome. I love it. I love it.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you for having us. And, you know, taking the time to consider Shaw University to participate in this. So we do appreciate that. And, you know, we hope to see some applications, you know, come in, and hope we could do this, you know, again.
Absolutely.
So just shoot us an email and we will be there.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Thank you guys for joining. Ryan, again, thank you so much for your time. Everybody, you guys have a great day. Stay safe.
Thank you so much. This was great. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye now.